गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, वेलकम टू योर अकाउंटेंसी क्लासेस। वी हैव डन चैप्टर वन। टुडे वी विल डू क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ चैप्टर वन। दिस ट्यूटोरियल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज टू दिस क्वेश्चन आंसर्स द होल चैप्टर विल बी रिवाइज टू यू सो दैट यू कैन गिव आंसर्स एट द टाइम ऑफ यू टी वन पेपर। ओके, टू टेक दिस वीडियो वेरी सीरियसली। वट एवर द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स आई एम कवरिंग, I will 90% paper will be covered from these questions only. Okay, maybe it is possible that the question will be asked in a different way, but the answer is the same, the content will be the same. Okay, so let's see. First, I am taking the notes. Accounting reports, transaction and events that can be measured in terms of money. Is this in your opinion a limitation of accounting or an advantage? So yes, tell me, try to say. If you are recording only those transactions which can measure in terms of money, so we have studied there that there are so much things in the business which will affect the business result, but we cannot measure them in terms of money. Only because of that we cannot record them. Like strikes are taking place, our good employees are giving resignations. All these things we cannot measure in terms of money. That's why we cannot record in the books of accounts also. So this is the limitation of accounting. Okay, that we can only record those transactions which can be measured in terms of money. So this is a limitation. Next, resignation by a marketing manager is not recorded in the books of account. Why? Because we cannot measure this resignation loss in terms of money. That's why we cannot record the same also. Next is, bookkeeping is not a part of accounting. Do you agree with the statement? Question is saying bookkeeping is not a part of accounting. So answer will be no. This statement is false. Bookkeeping is a part of accounting. Bookkeeping is the first stage of accounting because identifying the transaction, measuring in terms of money and recording and classifying. That work of accounting is done under bookkeeping. Okay? That work is done under bookkeeping. So bookkeeping is the primary stage of accounting. Now the next is the basic objective of bookkeeping to maintain systematic records or to ascertain net result of operation or financial transaction? Now the basic objective of bookkeeping, what is the objective of bookkeeping? So the basic of objective is only of the recording. Bookkeeping is limited only to the recording. Now calculating the net result or ascertaining the net results of operation or financial transaction, that is done by accounting. Bookkeeping is only limited to the recording. So what is the basic objective of bookkeeping? Is to maintain systematic record. Okay, ascertaining net profit is the objective of accounting, not bookkeeping. Next, recording the transaction and events correctly and preparing financial statements are the only objective of accounting. That you will record the transactions and then you will prepare the financial statement. Only these are the objectives? No. After ascertaining that result, okay, after recording the transactions and after that preparing the financial statements. Okay, I am reading the question again. Recording the transactions and events correctly and preparing financial statements are the only objective of accounting. Do you agree? Answer will be no. Question is saying accounting objective are limited only to the recording of transaction and preparing of financial statement. No. After that, after preparing the financial statement means one statement, that is income statement through which we will calculate our net profit and net loss. And second is the balance sheet, which is our financial position statement also, through which we will ascertain our assets and liabilities. So after preparing the financial statement, we will ascertain our net profit and net loss. After that, we will communicate the result to the interested parties and will have the management to take the decision and further corrective steps. Okay, so that much work is there. Okay, it is not only limited to recording and preparing the financial statement. So the statement is not correct. So answer will be no. After that, question number 6. Which type of accounting information shows profit earned or loss income? In this part, the previous answer I have also told you that net profit or net loss is ascertained by income statement or statement of profit and loss. We can say income statement or we can use the word of profit and loss account. Okay, so this will be the answer of this question. Now next is question number 7. State whether the following statements are true or false. Accounting may be influenced by the personal judgment. Then answer will be yes, because whenever we are applying the various principles and concepts of accounting, personal judgment is very important. So accounting is yes, influenced by the personal judgment. Next, financial statements are not comparable. False. We have done this in accounting information also, that accounting information should be comparable. Same for the financial statement also, they are made in the form so that they can compare with each other. Next, accounting information must be presented in such a way that only accounting people understand it. No, it is represent in a way so that a layman can also understand. Okay, it should be used the common language, so it should be prepared in the simple language so that every person can understand it easily. Now the next is, accounting information must be reliable. Yes, it is true. Accounting information should be reliable. That means it should be true and correct, so that we say that accounting information is reliable. Now let's do the MCQs. Bookkeeping and accounting mean same and are used interchangeably. That means bookkeeping and accounting are same. Second, does not mean same and are not used interchangeably. They are saying that they are not same and they are not used interchangeably. And our next is C. D. C means both A and B. That means both are the answers. And D, none of the above. So the answer will be, does not mean same and are not used interchangeably. Bookkeeping and accounting, both are the different terms. Okay, they are not same. Under bookkeeping, we are identifying, recording and classifying the transactions. In accounting, we are doing the separate work, that is calculating or ascertaining the net profit and net results, after that communicating the results. So both are doing the separate work. Okay, so they cannot be same. Bookkeeping is a routine work and accounting is an analytical work, so they cannot be same. Okay, so answer will be B. Does not mean same and are not used interchangeably. Next, accounting includes bookkeeping, does not include bookkeeping, may or may not be include bookkeeping, and D is none of these. The answer will be yes, accounting includes bookkeeping, because when we are doing the definition of accounting, it starts with identification and recording of the financial transactions, and in bookkeeping we are doing the same work. So that's why we are saying bookkeeping is a part of accounting, and when it is a part of accounting, accounting includes bookkeeping. Okay, so answer will be A part. Now next is third part. Which of the following will not be recorded in the books of accounts? Sale of goods. It is measured in terms of money. When we are doing the sales, we know the amount, how much of amount we are having as sales. Next, payment of salary. That transaction also can be measured in terms of money. We know that how much salary we have paid. Quality of stuff. Can we measure this term in money? No, we cannot measure the quality of the stuff in terms of money. So it cannot be recorded in the books of account. So answer third is C. Fourth, bookkeeping is concerned with recording financial data relating to business operation. So basically bookkeeping is related to recording. Next, see the next part. Designing for systematic records, classifying and summarizing record data. Now summarizing is the part of accounting. Summarizing, where we are preparing the financial statements. Okay, so summarizing is the part of accounting. It cannot be related to bookkeeping. So this is a wrong answer. Interpreting data for internal and external users. Interpretation and analytical work is also done by accounting, so it cannot be part of bookkeeping. All of the above. If two parts are not there, all of the above cannot be there. So only single A answer is there. Recording financial data relating to business operation. Bookkeeping is concerned basically with the recording of financial data. So fourth part is A answer. Now fifth, which is the last step of accounting as a process of information. The last step of accounting is to communicate the information to the users. We have done in the definition part, that's why I'm directly selecting the answer. Okay, the last step of accounting is to communicate the information to the users. Okay, So this will be the last step. So fifth answer will be C part. In case of fifth answer is C part, communication of information. Now let's move further. Basic functions of financial accounting is to. Now financial accounting basic function is record all business transactions. Basic function is to prepare the record. Second, interpret financial data. Assist the management. None of these. So if we talk about the basic function, that means the very basic, the starting point, moolbhoot. Okay, so the basic function of financial account is recording, because everything depends upon recording. We are summarizing it, we are preparing the results, we are communicating the results. So all that things are basically related with the recording of whole business transaction. So the basic function of financial accounting is to record all business transactions. Now seventh part, transactions are posted into ledger account form. We are doing this posting from journal book. Okay, we do the practical there, you will come to know that what is journal book and what is ledgers. But remember one thing, in bookkeeping we are preparing the journal, and after the journal entries are posted to ledgers, and on the basis of ledgers we are preparing the financial statements. Now eighth part, which of the following is not a business transaction? You have to identify which is not a business transaction. Business transaction, now which will not be business transaction, which will not affect the business, basically that will be the business transaction. First, purchase of goods for resale amounted to ₹50,000. You are purchasing the goods so that you can resell, that is related to business. You are doing for business so that you can earn the profit, so it is a business transaction. Paid salaries and wages, you are paying the salary because workers are working for the business, so again it is related to business. Next, paid rent of office premises. If you are using office premises for businesses, so you will pay the rent, so again it is related to business. Next, purchase a LCD for personal use. Is it related to business? You are purchasing a LCD for your personal use, to use at home. This LCD is not related to your office work, so that's why it is not a business transaction. It is not a business transaction. Now, the ninth part, which of the following transactions will not be recorded in the books of accounts? Basically, the transactions which cannot be measured in terms of money, or the transactions which are not related with the business, they will not record it. Now, let's see options. Purchase a LCD for personal use, paying the amount from personal bank account. You are using the LCD for personal use, and plus you are paying the amount personally. So nothing is affected of business. Either you are paying the amount from business account or you are using the LCD for business use, then only it will be affect our business. Now it is related to our business. But now you are purchasing the LCD for your personal use, and secondly you are making the payment also personally. So it will not affect the business. Okay. So it is not a business transaction. So answer will be A part. For the ninth, answer is A part. Now 10th, accounting does not show the realizable value of business. It is an, now when we are saying that you cannot show your realizable value, it is a limitation of accounting, because every person want to know that what is the realized value, but accounting cannot tell that. Okay, so it is a limitation of accounting. Which of the following is not an internal user of financial statement? Internal users we have done. So lenders are not internal users, because they are not lying within the business, they are outside from the business. So lenders means the person who has given the money to you as a loan. Okay, jisne aapko udhar diya hai, they are the lenders, so they are outside from the business. That's why they are not internal users, they are external users. So answer will be D part, lenders. Next, which of the following is not a characteristic of accounting? Recording non-monetary transaction. We are doing from the starting that we will record the monetary transaction, the transactions which can be measured in terms of money. So the answer will be non-monetary transactions. We cannot record such transactions in the accounting. So this is not a characteristic of accounting. Answer will be A part. Now 13th, which of the following is a limitation of accounting? Limitation of accounting, you are going to tell, giving assistance to management. If you are giving assistance to management, then it is an advantage, you are helping the management. Replace memory. there is no need to memorize the things because you are having the record in your hand. So again, this is an advantage. Evidence in court. You can use your books of account as an evidence in the court to prove something. So again, it is an advantage. Unrealistic information. This is not an advantage. So this will be the limitation. Question is asking for limitation. These 3 points are the advantages. So this will be the limitation. Unrealistic information. The information provided by the books of account, sometimes it is unrealistic. So this is the limitation. Okay. Now the next. Cost of goods manufactured is determined by cost accounting. Whenever we are talking about cost, we have to calculate the cost. It will be determined by cost accounting. Now the next is, qualitative characteristics of accounting include. Qualitative characteristics of accounting includes, basically this is related to accounting information. So accounting information we have done there. Reliability and relevance, yes, it should be there. Understandability and comparability, yes, it should also be there. That means both the things are there. So answer will be both A and B, because all these 4 are qualitative characteristics of accounting information. Next is, which of the following is not a qualitative characteristic of accounting information? We have done there. We have done that accounting information should be reliable, it should be comparable, it should be understandable. But materiality characteristic we have not done. Okay, so answer will be materiality. Okay, now the next is 16. Which qualitative characteristic of accounting information is reflected when accounting information is clearly represented? Now here we are saying that if you are presenting your information clearly in a simple language so that everyone can understood, because it is related to presentation. Presentation is very important, because on the basis of presentation you are going to understand the things. So which qualitative characteristics is highlighted here? Then answer will be, yes, try to find out the answer. Answer will be understandability. When we are clearing presenting our information, that means understandability is enhanced. Okay, so which qualitative characteristic we are talking about? Understandability. Now the next part, which external user of accounting information is most interested in knowing the long-term solvency position of the firm? They are asking external users. So the employee is internal, management is internal. Now only 2 are there, bank and researcher. Both are outside, but which is more interest to know in knowing the long-term solvency? Then answer will be bank. Long-term solvency means aap future mein, lambe samay mein, apni udhariyon ko chukane mein kitne saksham hai. Long-term solvency. Okay. So regarding long-term solvency, the institution which is more interested in the books of accounts or in the company, that will be bank and financial institution. Why? Because they have provided the loan to the business. So they want to know that in future you will repay, you are able to repay the loan or not. Okay. So that is the long-term solvency position. Solvency means your capability regarding paying your debts in long term. Debts means udhariyan. So that's all for the today. You will do these questions in your notebook. PDF I will send to you. Short answer questions are also there. You will write down in your notebook that short answers question. Long time, long answer type question we are not doing right now. Only short type questions we are doing from lesson 1 and lesson 2. Okay, but complete this work. Now, thank you, class.